as an intruder.
IRS, the CIA, the Federal Reserve.
He cut my phone line, can't dial out. I scream for police, but I doubt they're gonna hear me when I shout.
This war is a mistake, and it was a mistake to go in. We're losing this win. We shouldn't be there. We ought to just come home.
We dug a hole for ourselves, and we dug a hole for our party.
It was a mistake to go, so it's a mistake to stay.
We can achieve much more in peace than we could ever achieve in these seamless, unconstitutional, undeclared wars.
FBI and the Secret Service raided the National Fulfillment Office and confiscated all the gold, silver, platinum.
But the dollars represent much more, a mistrust of the current system of monetary policies in the United States.
When Ron Paul was firing every revolver in Ben Bernanke's direction, there was a lot of people cheering down here.
There, and people's money is being stolen. People who have saved, they're being robbed. I mean, if you have devaluation of the dollar at 10%, people have been robbed of 10%. But how can you pursue this policy without addressing the subject that somebody's losing their wealth because of a weaker dollar, and it's going to lead to higher interest rates and a weaker economy?
Why don't we run on George Bush's foreign policy of a humble foreign policy and no nation building? Okay. Don't we remember that when you sacrifice liberty for security, you lose both? How many more do you want to lose? How long are you going to be there? How long? What do we have to pay to save face? That's all we're doing is saving face. It's time we came home.
I think we're going to have a collapse before they come around to really thinking seriously, you know, about monetary policy and why we have to revamp it. Recently, we have seen the dollar go down sharply. I think it's going to continue, and hopefully it'll wake the people up and find out you have to have honest money, follow the Constitution because it says only gold and silver can be legal tender.
Shrinking dollar. The dollar falling again against the euro today after that weak new home sales number. In fact, in the last year, the dollar's dropped 10% against the euro. The euro now costs about $1.41. And it's not just the euro. Last week, the dollar hit a three-decade low against the Canadian dollar. This morning, the greenback hit a record low against a basket of six major currencies. It was tracked by the New York Board of Trade. We're talking about the dollar index.
Get the Dow Jones is up 105 points. This on a day when oil was up to a new time high of $96.67. Gold was up, the dollar was down, but look at those triple digits, and NASDAQ's doing well.
Only
also.
Six Dow components are down.
So the government reported the GDP last week. They said our economy grew 3.9%. But to make that, the government assumed annualized inflation was running at 0.8%. Now, there's no way that's true. If the government was accurately reporting inflation, we think we would know we're in a recession. You guys have to start looking at real numbers. You talk about the Dow up about 100 points today. If you price it in Canadian dollars, it's down almost 100 points.
We have not had a presidential candidate who talked about free markets, who talked about monetary reform, who talked about tax reform the way Ron Paul does since Steve Forbes ran for president. Bravo, bravissimo, go Ron Paul.
Americans, us as a citizen, gotta protect ourselves. Look at it's been, we better check ourselves. Living up in these streets, the worst are through better health. Surviving by any means, we as Americans, us as a citizen. We as Samaritans, what do we get us in? We better check ourselves. Look at how it's been, take a look where you live.